Hey, I'm Sarah. I'm with Future Generations University, and today we're going to be talking about how to actually assemble our rocket stove sap evaporator. You're going to have two options. If you're working with a grinder and a welder, you're going to be cutting it from sheet steel, and so that you're going to be working with more pieces like we have here. If you have a plasma cutter, you may be able to use tubular steel, which is going to give you less cuts and fewer welds. If you're working with sheet steel, you're going to start by cutting out all your pieces. We've gone ahead and done that, and we've got everything laid out here. I am going to begin with one of my chimney sides as the bottom piece, and I'm going to be welding to that so that I get my 8-inch square chimney. So, got the chimney side, I'm going to use my chimney front top and go ahead and get it set up with our magnets that help us make sure our tacks are 90 degrees. And I'm going to do the back the same way. Once I've got those tacked, I'm going to add my chimney front bottom, which has the ash pan cut out, as well as the wood box frames. So I'm going to add my wood box top here, and then the wood box bottom there. At that point, I will put the other chimney side on and go ahead and have a whole thing assembled. Add the chimney base, which gives the whole thing a solid bottom. And then the last piece we'll put in is our wood chute ledge, which will slip in between and get tacked. And that gives your wood a place to slide in with airflow. Now, if you have the advantage of being able to work with tubular steel, we're going to actually just be, we've got our tubular steel piece, we've got our cutout for the wood chute, and then we've got our cutout for the ash pan. And those are the only cuts we had to make there. And we've already got our angled piece for the wood chute, and we'll be welding it in place like this.
I'm Danny. I'll be doing the welding for the rocket stoves for Future Generations today.
We've got our holes cut in the tubular steel, but we need to clean up the cuts so that we have a nice clean surface for tacking and welding. So we're gonna do that, and then we're gonna go ahead and put it all together. Thank you. probably one of the trickiest parts of what we're going to be doing today is putting together the flame spreader. So this is one that's complete. This one was made out of sheet steel and bent, and so it only has a single joint. But we're going to make ours piecemeal. So we've got our four pieces cut out like this, and then this is our pattern that we used, and it has an indicator line of where a little stilt goes. And that stilt is going to help us get our angle for welding it all together. So I've gone ahead and traced where that line is on all of our flame spreader pieces. We're going to tack the stilt to the flame spreader pieces and then use that stilt to get the angle. And then we're going to tack all four pieces of the flame spreader to make the whole thing. And now we've got our flame spreader all tacked together. Okay, so now we're gonna cut our barrel for the chimney to go inside. It's important to note that your barrel's got a little bit of a lip on the bottom. So I've got all of our measurements go from the ground to make sure they end up in the right spot. So we come from the ground 13 inches up and we cut a rectangle that is 8.5 inches by 12.75 inches. And then we've got, for our ash pan, come up an inch and then we go 3 inches by 7 inches, and that's centered on the rectangle for the chimney. And then the other thing we're going to cut is exactly opposite that. We're going to cut out a 6.75 inch circle that is where our coupler for the chimney pipe is going to go, the stove pipe is going to go. And then the other cut that we are making is in the lid. We've already cut this one with a plasma cutter. You could use a jigsaw with a metal blade if you don't have a plasma cutter. You're gonna trace your evaporator pan, our stainless steel 30 quart brazier pan, trace it, and then cut that hole out centered on the lid. Kiln insulation that I'm going to use to insulate the firebox. You can get them in different size rolls, so you may need to cut your piece a little bit. We've cut ours to fit, and so we've got it kind of wrapped around, and I'm going to go ahead and just stuff this scrap piece in there too. It doesn't hurt to have a little extra insulation in there to protect the barrel.